absence of the unbalanced amplified force, a body at rest remains at rest. And a body already in motion remains in motion with constant.
Yes, but only if we're going out with a group.
Constant speed and direction is the law of inertia.
Deal. So for you can invite anyone to come with us.
Are you sure?
To set up a table, put a smooth tablecloth, heavy plastic cups.
I refuse to go with you to see a movie if that snooty stuck up.
Come on, Nyx, please. Say yes.
Capital N-O. No.
Come on, please, just this once.
Okay.
All right.
How's your day,
Good
guys?
Evening, Dad. Dad, Joey agreed to go on a date with me.
How are you? How was your day?
Oh, my day was fine, Sir Chief. What about you, Sir Chief? How was your day? Oh, what I really meant to say was, how was your day?
You thought I was out on a date again?
Well, you see, Sir Chief...
Just because I said that I'm open to dating doesn't mean that it's the only thing I'm doing all the time.
I knew you'd say that, Sir Chief.
One, two, three!
Little Park Eatery? Thank you, Mom! Baby?
Will Simone bring you to work today?
Oh, no, Sir Chief. I'll just take the bus today.
Text me when you get home later. And do your best. As I've said before, be confident.
Okay, sir. When you copy someone's work, it's called plagiarism.
It's a good thing Miss Delphine found out the truth.
You can't keep a secret forever. So there, I let them get on with their lives.
You didn't mind what?
Sir Chief?
Are you having trouble with your internship?
Well, I would have been in trouble, but I got out of it. But two interns were reprimanded. And then my trainer was so happy with what I did today.
Good.
We don't jive. It's already our third date.
I'm sorry.
Don't be. We're just too different.
Maya? What are you doing here? What's that?
Here you go. I bought a gift for you, Sir Chief.
That's sweet of you, Maya.
Bye, Sir Chief. Let's go.
Nanny, you work here?
Oh, baby, it's not actual work. I'm just an intern at this company.
Can I go inside?
No, baby. I would love to take you inside, but I can't. It's not allowed. My supervisor and the person who trains us is inside. And I wouldn't be able to watch over you. But don't you worry, baby. After I have my picture taken, I will come out here immediately.
Okay.
All right, baby?
Abby misses you already.
I know, she really does, Joma. All right, baby.
Okay, Nanny.
Hey, Joma, just watch over her for me. Bye!
Thank you, ma'am. All right, ma'am.
Okay.
Good morning, Ma'am Ina.
Good morning, Maya. You're early again today.
Oh, yes, I am, ma'am. It's because I need to be back at the house as soon as possible. I've been gone most of the week, so I really need to make up for all the time I wasn't there.
What about your gift? For Sir Chief. Did I get it right?
That's
so, did he like it?
Well, I don't know, but I was able to give my gift to him a while ago. But still, I have no idea if he liked it or not.
Why do you say that?
You see, he didn't seem that excited when he opened the gift. But it's okay with me, Ma'am Ina. What's important is that I was able to thank him through my gift.
I hope that all interns have a positive attitude like you, Maya. Anyway, I have to go.
All right, Ma'am Ina.
That's enough, man. You look gorgeous.
Maya, do that later. We're going to have our pictures taken.
It's okay, Wilson. We're not doing anything yet anyway. Besides, I might not have time to read this at home.
Oh, all right.
Good morning, interns. Are you ready for the picture taking?
Yes, ma'am.
Is everyone here already? Where's Jessica and Jane?
We're here, ma'am. We were just waiting outside.
Yes.
Oh, I see. By the way, before I forget, tomorrow you'll have hands-on training at the airport.
I'm expecting everyone to be early,
since we'll all be leaving together from Time Airways. And after that, Miss Ruiz and I will choose whom among you is fit to be assigned at the airport.
Oh my god!
I'm so
excited! That's great! That's exciting!
And of course, those who won't be chosen, they will be assigned here in the office. So good luck, guys!
Okay!
Thank you, ma'am!
Thank you, ma'am!
Wilson?
Did you hear that?
The airport?
Yes!
So we're going
we
to be like
this.
Real flight attendants
Come
now!
On, let's do this
yes, I know, Maya. I hope they'll choose us.
I know we can do it!
Maya,
pajama? Where's Abby? Jama, have you seen my baby girl?
No, I haven't seen her.
What? You haven't seen her? Oh, no. Well, all right. Besides, since Abby isn't here anyway, I'll just go back inside.
Go ahead.
I know, and that's why I missed you so much. And you are the best little girl I've known ever. So, you want to eat ice cream already?
I do!
All right, baby, we'll get you some ice cream. But I hope you don't mind. Is it okay if I review my lessons while we are eating our ice cream? Because tomorrow we'll be training at the airport. If I do good and impress them, they'll assign me there.
That's great.
I'll help you, Nanny.
That's the reason why I love you so very much. Come on, let's go.
Hey, dude.
Hmm?
Do you think Joey's going to show up?
She did say yes, right?
She did.
There you go. Then she'll come.
Well, what if Joey changed her mind? You know what they say about women? They always change their minds.
Dude, just try and relax. Don't worry, she'll be here, okay? Have some popcorn first. Want some?
Thanks.
Dude.
Hang on, dude. I need to text Nikki. Maybe Joey changed her mind. That's why they're not here yet.
You know what, Luke? You always underestimate me.
Joey.
Nanny, what will you do in the airport?
Well, baby, Nanny will help a lot of people at the airport.
Oh, like you helped me, Nanny?
Oh, wow, you still remember that, baby?
Mm.
That's right, like how I helped you, but now I'm very sure I won't need to help out a naughty kid on the conveyor belt.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Hey!
Hey, kids, get lost out of
hey,
here.
Hey, Joma, don't say that, it's all right.
Nanny, can I give them my ice cream?
Oh. Wow, baby, you really are so sweet. Oh, all right, I'll give them my ice cream, too. Here you go.
Thank you, miss.
You really think that I'm the kind of person who doesn't keep her word?
No, Joey, it's not what I meant. It's just that...
It's just that my best friend, Luke, already bought the popcorn and the tickets. And he was worried about it going to waste if you girls didn't show up. I know that sometimes you girls have things to do in your West Theatro Club, so he was worried. Isn't that right, Nikki Grace Lim?
Whatever.
Thank you! Thank you! You are all so kind, thank you!
Okay, goodbye.
You're welcome.
Come on, baby.
Nanny, can I have that one?
What, those flattened bottle caps?
Yes, Nanny.
The movie hasn't started yet, but we've run out of popcorn already.
I ate it all. You guys took too long.
No, it's okay. I'll just buy more popcorn.
No, wait, I'll do it. Let me.
No, Luke, you paid for the tickets. It's only fair that I should pay for the popcorn, okay?
Okay. Let's go.
We're good, Jem, and the others.
What a pity Louis couldn't come.
I know.
Nikki Grace Lim, what do you want? We'll ask your brother to buy it for you.
All I want is to be away from you. There. Isn't this great?
Just a little more.
This is how we do it in our province.
Nanny, can I help?
Oh, I don't think so, baby. Don't try. You might accidentally hit your finger.
But I can do it, Nanny.
All right, baby, but you have to promise Nanny that you will only do this while I'm around, okay?
Yes, Nanny.
All right, take this. Here.
Children shouldn't do this without an adult.
Oh, baby, be careful, you promise? There, put the bottle cap on the stone face up.
good.
Yes, that's good. Do it that slow. You'll be done after 2 years.
What is all that noise?
Uh-oh.
Are you going to go around and sing carols?
Oh, no, Ma'am Fair. We'll just sing for Sir
Chief. Yes, Ma'am Fair. So he'll allow us to have a Christmas break?
That's right. Is Jama going home, too?
Don't worry, Ma'am Fair. He won't go home for the holidays. He wants to make a good impression. You know, since he just came back.
What about you, Ma'am Fair? Where are you going to spend Christmas and your New Year?
Didn't you know, Maya? Ma'am Fair doesn't have a grandchild or a child in the province to go home to. She just stays here. Her family is Sir Richard, Abby, Nikki, and Sir Luke. Isn't that right, Ma'am Fair?
What? I do have other relatives, but they are far from here. I can't travel long distances alone. All right, just continue doing that.
What's with her?
I just love the ending. It's the best ending I've seen.
I know, right? I'm glad they didn't get together in the end.
What? Do you even know what you're talking about? If you really paid attention to the movie, you'll know that it has a happy ending. Meaning, they got together in the end. What movie did you watch anyway?
Dude, is that true?
Come on, bro. We all know what you were doing. You were snoring so loud, no wonder you don't know what the ending was. Joey, are you okay?
I'm sorry.
It's not hard to make Joey laugh.
That's
like
so
anything.
You want a drink?
No, thanks. I'm okay.
Come on, dude. Don't embarrass me.
Ta-da!
Here, this is for you.
Darius?
Right, Isabel. We each get one instrument.
No, time to sing.
More.
So what do you want
I
to sing,
wait.
Huh?
Wait. It's nice,
you want
right?
To sing?
Time to sing. A five, a six, a five, six, seven, eight.
My parents might be wondering where I am.
Stacy, Megan, you want to go with me?
Yes, let's go.
Okay.
I'll take you home then.
No thanks, Luke. My parents will be fetching me.
Oh, is that so?
Yes, bye guys.
Bye.
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 Take care, okay?
Bye.
Joey.
Before I forget, I just want to say I really had a great time. Thank you, Luke.
Me too. I hope we can do this again.
Okay, but I'll only go out with you if you promise to be in the top 10 of our class. Next grading period. I know you can do it, Luke.
You bet I can. I'll be top 5.
Okay, bye.
Bye, guys. Bye, Nix. Bye.
Really? That's a promise, Luke.
Yes, of course. I'm going to make it happen. Come on. I have to start studying.
Hey, you really are serious.
I really am. Let's go.
Come on.
Yippee!
Sir Chief, you're finally home.
They made those instruments.
Hey, are you okay, Nanny Faye?
I'm okay, Richard. I'm fine.
Ma'am Fair?
I'm all right, Maya. I'm fine.
No, Ma'am Fair, you've been coughing so hard since last night.
Since last night?
Yes, sir.
Don't gang up on me. All I need to do is rest. Go on. Continue your singing. Go on.
Daddy, is Nanny Fair going to be all right?
Sir Chief, don't worry, I'll keep an eye on Ma'am Fair.
Come on, tell him.
Go ahead.
You do it. I won't do it.
You can do it. You tell
him. What's with you? Come on,
hurry
up and
tell him. You always talk to him, so you do it. Go on, now's your chance.
Luke and Nikki are on their way home.
Hurry up, you'll miss him.
You always have the courage to talk to him.
Let's wait for them so we can eat.
Come on, now's your chance. Look, he's gone. Your chance just left. You're all talking, nothing else.
Ma'am Fair, why are you still up? You haven't gone to bed yet?
Well, I'm just folding a few clothes.
Come on, Ma'am Fair.
Maya, are you here because Ricardo asked you to check if I'm really doing okay?
Well, he just can't help it, Ma'am Fair. I think that your cough seems to be getting worse every single day.
Something just got in my throat, but I'm fine now. I'm all right.
Ma'am Fair, I don't think it's that simple. That wasn't just something a while ago.
Both of you are alike. You and Ricardo are worrying over nothing. Go on, get up there. The children will be waiting for dinner. Go on.
But Are you sure that you're just fine? You don't feel sick?
Maya, you and Ricardo keep nagging me. You're exactly alike. You belong together.
Well, you're so funny, Memphe. Oh, all right then. But if you need anything at all, I'm just a floor away from you, all right, Memphe? Okay, Memphe, goodbye. Oh, Memphe? I forgot to tell you. You don't have to worry about anything. During the holidays, this Christmas and New Year as well, you and me and the whole family will be together. It will be a fun season for us, I promise. See you.
Bye. Oh, yeah.
Hi, Abby. Hi,
Dad. Hi, baby.
How was the movie?
Oh, it was great, Dad. And as for Joey, she was laughing so hard at Luke's corny jokes.
She was? Don't forget about your studies. You have to keep up your grades.
Oh, of course not, Dad. I mean, Luke and Joey even had a deal. Joey told Luke she'll only go out and watch a movie again if he lands on the top 10 list of his class this grading period, which I know you can easily achieve.
Thank you for believing in me, Nix. But Dad was asking me, yet you answered. You're just like Niccolo.
Excuse me? Don't you ever compare me to that troublemaker freak.
Why shouldn't I? Both of you are so stubborn.
Maya?
Sir?
How's Nanny Fe?
She's doing much better, Sir Chief.
Did you really check on her?
Yes, Sir Chief. I asked her again and again if she's okay.
What did she say?
What? Well, Mamfe said that you and I belong together. Well, I think she meant to say that we both keep on nagging her.
Excuse me.
Oh, Sir Chief!
Didn't Maya tell you that I'm doing okay?
I just wanted to make sure, Nanny Fe. I can take you to the hospital tonight.
What's with you, Ricardo? You don't have to go through all that trouble just for my sake. I'm just fine. I'm okay.
I'm just worried, Nanny. You had an asthma attack before, right? You might have another attack.
You know what? This is probably because of the change in season. That's why I'm coughing.
Maybe Doris or Sabel can stay here so you'll have someone to help you during the holidays.
Come on, Ricardo. I think that Maya and I can handle everything. We can do it. Let those girls go home. All right, okay. I'll tell you what. If this cough persists until tomorrow, I'll ask Maya to go with me to the doctor. Is that okay with you?
All right, Nanny Fe. Now get some rest.
I will. Thank you, Ricardo.
All right. Maya?
Oh, Sir Chief, you want some coffee?
No, thanks. Can you check on Nanny Fe? If her cough still persists tonight, inform me right away, okay?
Okay, I will, Sir Chief. I'll take good care of Mamfe tonight.
Okay.
All right, Sir Chief.
Hey, Maya. You're still awake. What time is it?
Well, I'm excited, Mamfe. I can't sleep because I'm so excited. Because our supervisor told us today that we'll be training at the airport tomorrow.
All the more that you have to go to sleep. If you don't, you'll be so sleepy, you'll surely have a hard time.
I will. I'll sleep in a while, Mamfe.
Maya, I heard what Ricardo told you, for you to look after me. But that doesn't mean you have to watch over me the whole night. You might get sick if you do that.
I know, Mamfe. And I'll go to sleep later when I'm done studying. Don't worry about me.
You and Ricardo are so stubborn. You never listen.
Mamfe? Mamfe? Are you okay? Oh, dear. Mamfe, hang in there while I get some help. Oh, no. Doris?
Sabel?
That sounds like Maya.
You're right. Where is Sabel?
What?
It's Manfair.
What happened
What's
to her?
What's going on? She's having trouble breathing.
What?
What's wrong? But why? Yes. Could you go to her and watch over her? I'll just let Sir Chief know. Then I'll tell Jama to get the car ready because we might need to bring her to the hospital. All right,
All right.
We will.
We'll prepare the things Mam Fei will need at the hospital.
That's right. All right, thank you, guys.
Go now, Maya.
I wonder what happened to Mam Fei. Let's hurry up, Doris. Sir Chief? Sir Chief? Sir Chief? Sir Chief?
Maya.
Sir Chief, I'm sorry to disturb you, but Mam Fei is having trouble breathing.
What?
I asked Jama to get the car ready. Sabel and Doris are preparing Mam Fei's things. What's going on?
Oh, we'll just go out and buy some medicine for Nanny Fei. Nikki, go back to sleep.
Okay, Dad. Good night.
Good night.
Sir Chief, aren't you going to tell Mam Nikki the truth?
I don't want to make them worry.
Okay, sir. Poor Mam Fei.
Mam Fei, everything will be okay. We're going to the hospital now.
Maya, take care of Mam Fei for us, okay?
Make sure she's all right, okay?
Mam Fei.
Don't take your eyes off her, Maya.
Sir.
Please take care of the children. Don't tell them that we went to the hospital.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right, sir. Drive carefully.
Maya, take care of her.
Mam Fei. Oh, poor thing.
I know.
Mam Fei.
Drive carefully.
Hang on, Mam Fei, okay? We're here. Hold on to me. Slowly now, Sir Chief.
Come on.
Mam Fei. Easy now. All right, she's fine. Go ahead, mister. Mam Fei. Sir Chief, you want coffee?
All right.
Oh my, I wonder what's happening to Mam Fei.
Why don't you send a message to Maya so we'll know?
I already did. She hasn't replied yet.
It's your fault, Sabel. You must have asked Mam Fei to help you in the kitchen and it tired her.
Hmm? It wasn't just me. What about you? Mam Fei always helps you fold the laundry.
Hey, of course not.
Hmm? Hey, quit it, you two. Mam Fei is in the hospital now and you chose to fight?
You know he's right, Doris. Let's not fight anymore, or Mam Fei might get even worse.
Sabel, we're not actually fighting. We might snap and pick on each other, but it's really nothing. And it's just our way of caring.
I have an idea. Let's not go home.
Good idea, because if I go home, only you and Mam Fei will be left to do the housework, and most probably, Mam Fei will do most of my jobs.
Right, and in the end, she might get sick again.
You're right. So don't go home anymore.
All right, I'll call my sister to inform her.
I'll just send gifts to my family.
Me too.
I envy you. You have something to send. Me, I don't.
Because you spend a lot.
No, I don't.
Yes, you really do. You've borrowed from Mam Fei several times.
Mam Fei has always been so nice to us.
Come on, Doris. I know that look. Don't start now. I can't believe this.
Oh, my.
You are so annoying.
Come on, guys. Don't cry.
Sir Chief, here's your coffee.
I should have brought her to a doctor much earlier.
But you know, Sir Chief, you can't force Mamfet to do something she doesn't want to do.
I should have tried harder.
Don't worry about it, Sir Chief. I believe Mamfet will get through this.
How do you know? Nanny Fay is not young anymore. Even if they put her asthma under control, it could affect her heart. She could go into a coma.
Please don't say that ever again, Sir Chief.
And what do you want me to believe?
You have to have faith in Mamfe. Believe that she'll get better. And that she's very strong. Something like this isn't going to bring her down. And besides, don't ever forget that we have a saying that goes like, where there is life, there is hope. And where there is hope, there are good vibes. And where there are good vibes, good things always happen. So let's stop thinking about bad things that haven't happened yet.
Good vibes?
Yes, good vibes, Sir Chief. Good vibes. Sir Chief, the doctor is smiling.
Hi. I know. How is she, Doctor?
About the patient, she had an asthma attack due to so much stress and fatigue. And my professional opinion is it's probably from too much work.
But is she okay?
Yes, for now. We were able to open the patient's airways and nebulize, but I recommend that she stay here to rest. We also need to check her blood pressure and oxygen level from time to time. And then we need to do an ECG exam on her so we'll know her heart rate.
Okay, Doctor. Do everything so that she can recover.
Yes, Mr. Lim. We will.
Okay, Doctor. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Doctor. You see, I told you, Sir Chief. Good vibes work.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Nanny Fay?
Ricardo.
How are you feeling right now?
I feel much better.
Are you sure you're okay? Do you feel any pain in your body? Do you want me to call the doctor?
No need to do that. I'm doing better now. Maya, why are you crying?
Because you really scared me, Mamfe.
It was just an asthma attack. I'm not going to die yet.
Nanny Fe, let's not talk about such things.
But what do you want me to say?
I just want you to get some rest. We'll talk again later.
I'm not allowed to even talk?
You shouldn't tire yourself. Wait, what do you want, Nanny? Do you want me to go out and buy food for you? Do you want water?
Oh, I can get my own water.
Nanny Fay, you're not supposed to get up yet.
Why can't I? I didn't have a heart attack or anything. Why am I not allowed to
water.
Do so many things?
Hmm. I worry about you, Nanny Fee.
You don't have to worry about me. I'm fine, Ricardo.
It's only natural that I worry about you, because I love you.
Thank you. Thank you, Ricardo. You are so good to me. You know, the woman you'll marry is a very lucky woman indeed.
Like a grand lottery winner.
Maya?
Oh, well, what I meant, Sir Chief, was I agree. She's one lucky woman.
Don't disturb me.
You son of a... I mean daughter of my boss.
Oh my, good morning, Abby. Guys, it's morning already. Good morning, you have to get up now.
Why did you sleep here?
Good morning.
Good morning, sir. Well, you see, sir, Sir Luke,
we washed our clothes the whole night.
What? I mean,
we just awesome. Stories the whole night.
Huh?
Have you seen Dad? I was knocking on his door, but he didn't answer.
Me too. I can't seem to find Nanny.
What's going on here?
Her breathing is back to normal, Mr. Lim. And her ECG result is normal too.
How about her blood pressure?
It's back to normal. It's 120 over 80. But we need to take another day or two just to observe her condition. And if her normal breathing continues, we can release her, Mr. Lim.
Just do what you think is necessary, Doctor. If she needs to stay a few more days, it's okay.
Just make sure that she will avoid anything that would trigger a severe asthma attack.
Oh, what would trigger an attack, Doctor?
Well, allergens like dust, fur, feathers... Lack of sleep, fatigue, and stress.
Lack of sleep, stress.
She can't carry heavy things because her body's still weak and recuperating.
Okay.
She should also avoid certain food that may cause allergy.
Uh-huh.
Just like eggs, fish, and nuts. She should take extra caution in taking good care of herself. She needs complete bed rest, Mr. Lim.
All right, Doctor. Thank you.
Excuse me.
Nanny Fee, the doctor said you must take good care of your body. And you need complete bed rest. And you're not allowed to carry heavy things now.
When can I go home?
You need to be under observation for the next few days.
Can't I just rest at home and...
Nanny Fee, we need to follow the doctor's orders.
Maybe
Sir
your dad
Richard left
sleeping.
Very early this morning.
What?
Yes, Luke.
Dad, where are you? When we woke up, you weren't home, and Abby's looking for Maya.
I'm sorry, I told them not to tell you.
About what, Dad?
We rushed Nanny Fee to the hospital last night. She had an asthma attack.
She what? Is she okay now?
Yes, she's okay.
Why didn't you wake me up, Dad? I could have gone with you.
I asked Maya to accompany me.
Are there things you'd like us to bring to the hospital?
No, it's fine. I'll ask Doris to bring them. So you just focus on going to school. So you'd better get ready.
We will, Dad. What about you? How are you doing?
Oh, I'm fine. Don't worry about me.
Dad, you can always tell us whenever there's an emergency at home.
I know. But we've only recently recovered from what happened to your mother. And I didn't want to worry anyone.
All right, Dad. I'll explain everything to Nikki and Abby.
Okay. Tell them that Nanny Fee is doing well, so no need to worry, okay?
Yes, Dad.
Let me talk to Doris.
All right, Dad. Doris.
Sir?
Dad wants to talk to you.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Doris, you and Joma need to come to the hospital. Nanny Fair must have someone to watch over her. Because Maya needs to go to school, and I need to go to work. Please bring work clothes for me and Maya. I have to go straight to the office as soon as you arrive.
Okay, sir. We will, sir.
And, don't forget to bring clothes for Nanny Fair also. Bring some of her personal things.
All right, sir. I'll pack some of her things.
Bye.
You have nothing to worry about, Nix and Abby. Nanny Fair's okay now. She's recovering.
What worries me is that I saw Dad last night, but he never mentioned anything.
Don't be upset, Nix. Dad just doesn't want us to worry. I mean, look at you now. Stop frowning, will you?
I can't help it. I know how important Nanny Fair is to Dad.
You're right. Ever since Dad was a kid, Nanny Fair's been taking care of him.
Just like Nanny?
Yes, baby. Just like you and Maya.
I will pray for Nanny Fair.
Yes, baby, that's good. We should pray for her fast recovery and good health.
Maya, you have work today, right?
Yes, Ma'am Fair. Doris and Sabelle will bring me some clothes so that I can change here.
And where is your surchief?
Oh, Ma'am Fair, I think he's probably outside talking to the doctor.
Oh, do me a favor. Can you please call him? He has work today. I'm sure he hasn't eaten yet. There's some food over there. Can you get it? Please get it.
Here you go.
Tell him to eat. I don't want that boy to faint from hunger.
Ma'am Fair, just calm down. Don't worry about it. I'll take care of it.
Thank you, Maya.
Okay, Ma'am Fair.
There, maybe this one.
Oh, I see Maya! Maya! Hey, Sabelle, Doris, Joma, I'm so glad that you're here.
Maya, where's Ma'am Fair?
Oh, she's inside. Go on, you may go in. I'll look for Sir Chief. Well, anyway, we brought work clothes for you and Sir Richard. They're right here. Oh, okay, thank you.
Okay, guys, let's go inside.
Let's go.
Ma'am Fair? Sir Chief? Oh, Sir Chief? I didn't mean to wake you.
It's okay. Is Doris here?
They're inside Ma'am Fair's room, Sir Chief.
Let's go.
Okay, sir. Hello, Ma'am Fair. Look here, we brought flowers for you. They're pretty, huh? Doris and I bought these at the local market. Smell it. It smells so good.
Thank you, Sabelle. Have you eaten already?
Yes, Ma'am Fair. We all had breakfast. You wouldn't expect us to skip our meals.
Ma'am Fair, when can you go home?
Actually, I want to go home now. But Ricardo wouldn't let me. I think he talked to the doctor to let me stay here a few more days.
Maya, let's go.
Okay, Sir Chief.
Nanny Fair, we'll have to leave for work now. I'll come back here after work.
Thank you, Ricardo.
Nanny Fair,
what's wrong?
Nanny Fair. Maya, please call the nurse.
Oh, right away, Sir Chief.
Nanny Fair?
Hey, Wilson, where's Maya?
Oh, I really don't know. But she's never late, though.
Oh.
Good. At least we got here ahead of Miss Diana.
I knew it. We're too early.
It's okay.
Girl, I bought this one in Green Hills. It's like new. I really like it a lot.
I like that.
I know. Pretty, right?
Where did you buy that again?
Is everybody here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
As I've said yesterday, it's hands-on training at the airport today. Where's Maya de la Rosa? It's a pity if she'll miss this. Because your training today is very important.
Now she's in trouble.
Well, she deserves it.
It's been triggered by her allergy of pollens from flowers. Who brought those flowers? But she's okay now. Like I've said, we have to be very careful about things that might trigger her asthma.
Okay, doctor, thank you.
Sir, I'm sorry. I really didn't have any idea that flowers would trigger Mom Fest asthma. I'm really sorry. I didn't know.
It's okay. Joma?
Sir?
Go and take Sabelle with you to fetch Abby.
All right, sir. Mamfe, we'll go ahead.
Sorry, Mamfe.
It's okay, Sabelle.
We'll go now.
Take care, okay?
I'm really sorry.
It's your fault. See?
Ricardo, you and Maya need to go to work.
We'll stay here for a while, just to be sure.
There. Hang on, let me fix your hair a bit. Good. Now, here's your headband. There. Abby looks so pretty now. All right. Okay. Oh, what is it? Is there anything you want, Abby? Are you hungry?
Can I call Nanny? I want to talk to Nanny Faye.
Oh, you can. Sure thing. That's a good idea. I still have call credits. Hang on. There.
Oh. Hello, Sabelle.
Oh, hello, Maya. Abby wants to talk to you. Nanny is on the line.
Hello, Nanny.
Hi, baby.
Can I talk to Nanny Fay?
Oh, all right, baby. Hang on a second. Oh, Mam Fay, Abby wants to talk to you.
What? Hello, Abby.
Nanny Fay, please get well very soon.
Thank you so much, Abby.
I will pray for you tonight.
Thank you, dear. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Mam Fay, what did Abby tell you?
She said she's praying for me.
Oh no, Mam Fay, please don't start now. Don't do that. What you're doing will make me cry too. You know how I am, right? I easily cry and I'm such a crybaby. I never realized Abby could make us both cry.
Now I miss the children even more. Maya, do you think I can go home now?
Sir Chief, your coffee.
Thank you, Maya. Maya, I think we need to go home. There's no one to look after the children.
Oh, okay, Sir Chief. Let's say goodbye to Mam Fay first.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Nanny Fay, I've talked to the doctor. She told me that you can be discharged tomorrow.
Why can't I go home now? Where are you going?
Maya and I need to go.
Oh, you silly child. You don't want me to go home, yet you're leaving me.
We will be back tomorrow anyway, Nanny Fay. So can I fetch you? Is that all right?
Go ahead. I can't stop you anyway.
All right, Mam Fay. Goodbye, Doris.
Bye, Maya. Take care, sir.
Oh, great.
Hey, Sabelle, what are you doing?
What's wrong? I'm checking if there's still dust left. What's wrong with you? Sir Richard said Monfay's allergic to dust. Didn't you know that?
You know what? You could get another job.
What kind of job? Oh, I can be a hospital manager?
No. Now you can apply as a canine.
Canine? What is canine? What does a canine do?
Canine, those big dogs who sniff out bombs and drugs at the airports and malls. Yes, you can do that.
You're trying to be funny, huh? Hmm?
Well.
Mamfe, we're going home now. Oops. There.
Let's go, Nanny Fe.
I can walk.
No, wait, let me help you. Okay, be careful. Maya, let's go.
Oh, okay, sir. Oops.
No, John. Let's go home, let's John. Bring them to their office.
Where to now?
Let's go home first, so Nanny Fe can rest.
No, let's go to Ricardo's office, then we'll take Maya to her school. She can't afford to be late. I can rest here in the car anyway.
Oh, Ma'am Fe, it's okay. I need to go home first because I have to change my clothes.
Let's go home.
We're here, Manfe. We're home now. There.
I can do it, Ricardo. It's okay.
Nanny Fe!
Abby.
Welcome back, Manfe. We missed you so much. Oh, your room is now ready for you. Joma and I cleaned it very well.
Oh, thank you.
Nanny Fe, let's pass through
this
here.
This way.
It's faster to pass this way.
No, Manfe. You should go this way.
What?
Yes, ma'am. You see, Manfe, from this day on, you'll sleep in the guest room. What? Because you are now the household's very special guest. Let's go to the guest room.
What?
Yes, Manfe. Let's go, Manfe. Come on. Manfe has a very nice
bed
now.
Your room is so pretty, and it smells so good.
Ta-da! Here you go, Manfe. Take a look at your room. Not a single speck of dirt, and there is no dust. And most of all, it's air-conditioned. Now you'll never have an asthma attack.
Oh, Manfe, wait a minute. Where are you going?
I'm going to my room. I won't be able to sleep here.
Manfe, hold on. Manfe!
Sir Chief,
she's gone. Manfe!
By the way, I'm Ina. Katrina Ruiz.
Richard Lim.
You're Maya's boss?
I want a woman who will love you unconditionally. A woman who will love you and your family. Especially your children.
Nanny Fe, a woman like that doesn't exist.
You need me, Sir Chief?
I have the list of interns who will be assigned to the airport. Jessica Valdez, Jane Zamora, and...